This is David Trainer from New Constructs and Ed Lee from the New York Times. David, what's your take on these numbers? Because clearly the stock price reacting to the beat on revenue and the guidance on revenue, but the daily average users is down.
Yeah, we think the economics of this business are in real trouble, and the valuation is really untethered to the fundamentals. So this is a noise trader stock, right? These are people who invest in stocks like Snap who just don't care about fundamentals, and that works until it doesn't. And so if you really care about risk or fundamental risk, you got to stay away from this stock, because the expectations baked into the valuation are that they're going to be as profitable as Facebook and grow to be about half that size. So there's almost, from a risk-reward perspective, nothing good you can say about owning the stock at this price.
Ed Lee, what do you make of the numbers? And Julia made the point earlier that they're given guidance for the first time, and they didn't in the past. Do you read anything into that?
I think they're trying to sort of paint the forward-looking picture as, you know what, we're going to get there, we're going to get there soon. I do think, though, I agree that the numbers aren't great. They lost their two or three million on DAUs for the first time since they went public. This is supposed to be a growth company. This is supposed to be sort of a hockey stick type growth thing. We're not seeing that at this moment. They did go through an app redesign, which certainly hurt, I think, users. They redesigned it, though, to make it easier for newer users to come on. Clearly, that hasn't happened. I'd like to hear more. I want to get a better sense of what's happening to, you know, sort of the way that new people are supposed to use it, how they plan to combat Instagram. My 13-year-old, she spends most of her time on Instagram. She doesn't spend any more time on Snap or Snapchat. And so I think that to me was a telling sign.
David, is that the biggest threat, as opposed to the app redesign, just simply the innovations taking place at their rival Facebook and being able to copy the best things that Snap offers?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I think one of the most difficult challenges in the world of business is to have a large, firmly established incumbent with more capital, resources, and users than you that can simply follow whatever it is you do to make whatever innovation you create effectively not profitable. Or right now, I mean, or at least in 2007, Snap lost $6 for every dollar of revenue, okay? So cash flows are ridiculously poor. And yeah, the stock price implies they're going to be a huge growth company. And they got to take on this firmly established incumbent with worlds more advantage. It's really, again, it's a noise trader stock. People who are in this stock don't care about fundamentals, pure and simple. That can be a really good thing in the short term. Usually in the long term, it ends up being a very bad thing.
Yeah, there are a couple of stocks we've talked about that today. Thank you, guys. David Trainer and Ed Lee, good to have you on.
Thank you.
We should point out.